Hello everyone, this is Subbu, Nilesh and Shankar from Analytics Army team. We are working for LexisNexis account from Dayton, Ohio. As part of the hackathon event, we have chosen OpenTrack to build an autonomous analytics solution on the HPCC Big Data platform. As part of autonomous analytics, we are trying to address the problem statement of determining the actual productivity of the employee, project, delivery unit, business unit and the organization, which can be helpful in appraising the employees, unit, project, and the organization, and determine the employee arrival departure pattern, which can be helpful in planning the logistics and other infrastructures, internal as well as the external infrastructures. Our solution for this problem statement is to find out the actual productivity of the employee by considering multiple parameters, which can be classified as system can track parameters and system cannot track parameters. Here are the few system can track parameters can be considered as swipe in and swipe out information, browsing activities, work system usage and working from home item information and the leave details. And then we have system cannot track parameters such as time spent outside of workplace, communicator chats and improper meetings and calls. Here is the sample view of employee day-to-day activities from the time employee enters the office. Let's talk about the scope of our solution that we have considered for the hackathon event. To calculate the employee productivity, we are considering only two system can track parameters. One, employee attendance information at the workplace. Two, usage of internet at the workplace. Other parameters can be added as an enhancement to the solution. And to identify employee arrival departure patterns, analytics is being built on the employee swipe in and swipe out details captured at the main entrance. Our target customer for the solution would be senior management team, starting from delivery managers and above, HR team, CCD team, and the facilities team. Here are the few assumptions we have made while building this solution. One, we are limiting this solution only for ODBC, where we already have swipe machines installed to capture the swipe in, swipe out details closer to workplace. In order to accurately measure the productivity, attendance system should be enabled to read swipe in and swipe out details from the ODBC swipe machines. It will help to filter the hours spent outside the workplace, that is cafeteria, gym, etc. Three, CCD to capture the web activity logs of each employee, which will be used to determine the actual productive hours. We have built our technical solution on HPCC platform, which is an open source big data processing platform developed by LexisNexis. The analytics component, which is built on Thor, a HPCC data refinery engine, gets the information from attendance system and CCD web logs and analyze them on weekly, monthly and yearly basis to produce the below insights such as 1. Productivity of employee, project, delivery unit, business unit and the organization. 2. Pattern of employee office attendee hours. Analytics reports, which is built on Roxy, the HPCC data delivery engine, in integration with Google Charts, can be published for target customers. The outcome of our solution can benefit in the following ways. 1. Subjective discussion on employee productivity during the appraisal discussions can be removed. 2. Helps to engage the employees better to be more productive and have better work-life balance. 3. Helps to determine the productivity of the organization, which can be reported in annual report along with the resource utilization, which is being currently reported. 4. Helpful in planning the logistics infrastructure for the organization and to showcase the insights to the government for hitting the help on external infrastructure setup. Here are the few adoption challenges or outliers of our solution that we foresee. 1. Infrastructure setup to install the swipe machines at all the floors closer to workplace. 2. Item hovers can be used in place of workplace swipe in swipe out details. However, it will not give the accurate productivity as it is being manually entered in the system. Before we move forward with our solution demo, here is the basic environment setup that is required for HPCC. There are three basic components of HPCC. First one, HPCC node. We are using a single node Thor and Roxy cluster installed on virtual machine. Thor is a computation engine for performing ETL operations. Roxy is a querying and reporting engine for outside world. HPCC platform has inbuilt integration with Google Charts for reporting. Second one, ECL Watch. A web-based interface to communicate with Thor and Roxy clusters. It helps in input and output data file maintenance. Third one, ECL IDE. We use ECL IDE for development of HPCC applications, and IDE is similar to Eclipse IDE. ECL is the declarative language used for developing the code for HPCC applications. It is similar to PIC in the Hadoop ecosystem. Let's have a demo of our solution. We are using three input files for our solution. One, employee details, which is having 45 employee details. Two, employee attendance information, which is having the swipe in and swipe out details for the employees for 2 months, around 2000 records. Three, weblog details for the employees, which is having the website information and then website category and then time in and time out for 2 months, around 2000 records. All the above input files are loaded and sprayed using ECL Watch to create the logical files on the cluster for performing data operations. Okay, we have created the data sets from logical file to perform the analytics operation. Our solution is built on three core components on the Thor engine. One, attendance analytics. Two, weblog analytics. Three, time in, time out scoring for pattern analytics. We are generating three reports after the analytics. One, productivity reports. Two, summary reports. Three, pattern analysis reports. For productivity calculation, we are filtering out the default lunch hour and the non-productive browsing hours from the actual hours spent at the workplace. For pattern analytics, we have used the scoring logic. Scoring is done on every 15-minute interval around the default office hours, which is 8:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. On-time arrival and departure gets 0 score. Early arrival gets negative score and the late arrival gets positive score. Similarly, early departure gets negative score and the late departure gets positive score. Reporting queries built on using Roxy, two reports queries are built, employee productivity details monthly and weekly basis. I am running the productive tracker and the summary reports models to generate the three reports explained earlier. I have submitted the jobs and both of them are running. So both the jobs are completed now. So moving on to ECL Watch, where you could see both the jobs. I am going to pick up that summary reports. On that summary reports, we are going to see three different reports. And one is the bar chart that I am going to explain, where like the bar chart we are going to choose to display that the total productive and the non-productive hours rolled up for an individual delivery unit. And then the bubble chart. The bubble chart we are going to see, it will be displaying that the chart generated based on the arrival and departure scoring logic explained earlier. The size of the bubble shows the number of employees falling into that arrival and departure patterns. Then moving on to the Roxy, we are going to fetch the weekly productive details for the given employee using the Roxy web service. So we are going to feed in that employee details of a particular employee and then selecting that output table format and submitting it. So it produces the report with the weekly output details. So that's all about the demo of our solution. Thanks for providing an opportunity to showcase our solution at the hackathon event.